Today we will be demonstrating how to measure, cut, and bend a piece of EMT conduit to your desired length and angle. Begin by measuring the length of conduit that you will need. It may be easiest to do so by starting from a corner in the room and measuring to where the conduit will end, such as a converter box. You may find it useful to mark the conduit with a pencil where the corner should be. Next, you will need to measure the amount of extra conduit length required, also known as deduct length, as you lose some length due to the conduit bend. This amount varies depending on the diameter of the conduit you are using. For a 90-degree bend, a 1/2-inch conduit requires 5 inches of deduct length. A 3/4-inch conduit requires 6 inches. After determining the amount of deduct length and cutting to the size necessary, you should remove the burrs from the end of the conduit using a conduit reamer or knife. Your bender will typically have 3 to 4 distinctive marking features, including the 90-degree mark. This is the point where the bend conduit will reach a right angle. This is one of the more commonly used angle marks. Other angle marks can include 10, 22.5, 30, 45, and 60-degree angles. Finally, you will often find a stub height mark. This mark will usually list a number like 6 inches to use for the bender take-up. Slide the conduit into the bender, leaving the appropriate amount past the arrow on the bending shoe. Set the conduit on level, firm ground, and place your foot firmly on top of the foot pedal of the bender. Now, pull the bender handle towards you to create the bend with a firm and steady motion to avoid any kinks or crimps in the conduit. Ensure that your foot and hand remain securely on the bender, as any small slip in the conduit can create an off-center bend, meaning that you will need to start over with a new piece of conduit. Keep in mind that when you bend, you may need to slightly overbend the conduit in order to compensate for any spring back in the conduit. Make sure to do this slowly and carefully. Bend until you've reached your desired corner angle. Finally, check that your bend is the proper angle through one of several methods. You can hold it up to the wall, use a level held firmly against the front side of the pipe, or hold it to a surface that you know is level horizontally and vertically. You can view our entire product catalog featuring conduit, conduit benders, and much more at galco.com.